It is useful to describe how we can modify equations and how equilibrium constant values will be affected by that. So hopefully it makes sense that if we were to make any modifications to an equation by reversing an equation, by multiplying through by a constant, or adding equations together, our corresponding equilibrium constant will also be affected. We are going to describe each one of these. So we'll have three examples here. We're going to use this main equation as our starting point. And so to begin with, we're going to write our equilibrium expression. Notice we have a KC here, so we're going to use concentrations. So we have the concentration of C that is cubed. We have the concentration of A squared in the denominator times the concentration of B first order. And this is assigned an equilibrium constant of 2.56 times 10 to the minus 5. Given this value of Kc, we want to know what is favored at equilibrium. Recognize that this is a very small value. And so it means at equilibrium, we see a lot more of the A and the B in here. This is reactant favored. So we would see more of the A and B in our system, not so much of the C. Using that as our starting point, let's talk about what would happen if we were to reverse the above equation. So when I do that, of course, now it means that C is my reactant, and A and B, 2A and B, are my products. With this new equation, I'm going to write a prime here. Anytime we modify a k value, we use a prime, noting that it's not the original version, still valid, just not the original. And notice when I do this and write my equilibrium expression, I'm still writing it as products over reactants. So A is squared, B is first order. In the denominator, I have C cubed. What we should recognize is that this is exactly the inverse of our original Kc value. And so to get our new value, I take 1 divided by my original K value. Recognize that I would still have more A and B in my system at equilibrium. So now this is considered a product-favored reaction. When we take the inverse, we get a value of 3.91 times 10 to the fourth. So this is a large K value, which matches our prediction of a product favored system. The next possibility is to add two equations together, and we will actually see this in chapter 14. We want to know what our new value of Kc, and this should have a prime on it, what that new value is going to be. So first, I'm going to rewrite these equations so that I can then add them together. And to help, I'm going to write our Kc expression for each one. And number these. So Kc1, Kc2. For Kc2, we of course have b and d squared in the numerator. We have c squared in the denominator. Now, when I add my two equations together, remember, of course, from Hess's law that when we have the same substance on either side of the arrows, we can cancel it. And when they're on opposite sides, we can cancel. And technically, what we're doing is subtracting coefficients. So notice I have three carbons on the product side in equation one, or not carbons, two, sorry, three C's as a product in equation one. I have two C's as a reactant in equation two. And so I'm going to subtract those. That's going to leave me with one C on the product side. So my net equation here is going to be 2A in the gas state. That's my only reactant left over. I'm going to have 1C and 2D. Now, when I add these two equations together, notice that what I'm going to end up doing to find my new k value is to multiply my two expressions together. So here's my expression for the first equation. If I multiply that by my expression for the second equation, notice we do the same thing, right? We're canceling exponents, so we're left with 1c. Our b's cancel. And so our new expression, which matches our equation, is c to the first order, d squared in the numerator, and then we're left with a squared on the bottom. And so when we add two equations together, so sorry about this, not sure why it's doing all of that. When we add two equations together, we multiply the two k values to get our new one. And so that work is shown down here. When we multiply these together, we get a final value of 1.65 times 10 to the minus 12. The last option is if we multiply an equation through by a constant, and 3 was chosen randomly. But if I had different coefficients that were a multiple of something, either multiplying through by 2 or by 3, let's see how that will change our expression. So I'm writing my equation, multiplying everything through by a 3. When I go to write my prime KC expression, I have C raised to the ninth, A is raised to the sixth, and B is raised to the third. Now, if I compare this to my original equation from up above, my C is cubed in the original, A is squared, and B. Notice what I've done is I've raised each of my substances to the third power. Not to the third power. Sorry. I just misspoke. I essentially multiplied each of my exponents. Sorry about that. Multiplied each of my exponents by the value that I multiplied by. And so, in short, my new k value is kc, where each quantity, the exponent of each one, is multiplied by 3, which means my overall k value then gets raised to the third power. So again, down here at the bottom, essentially what I've done is I've raised my equilibrium constant to the power of the value that I multiplied through by. So my Kc cubed becomes my new Kc value. So Kc prime would be my 2.56 times 10 to the negative fifth. I cube that. This is the number I multiplied through by. And that gives me my new value of 1.68 times 10 to the minus 14. So when you multiply through, you raise your equilibrium constant to that power. The last slide in here are practice questions for you. So given these three equations down here, you're asked to perform these steps. Here are the resulting equations. Practice calculating the new equilibrium constants for these.